Hey everybody, Hunter back again from Showtime Studios. Today we're going to be doing a kit review. This is on a kit that I have a couple of the original releases of it, and it's been many, many years since they have released this kit, or actually re-released it. And the kit that we're talking about is the Super Boss kit, Tyrone Malone from AMT. It seems to be a pretty decent kit. I've got everything laid out here, and we'll be going through all the parts and pieces and kind of give you my thoughts on it and things to maybe look for, and we'll go from there. So first off, we have the box art, which is a picture of the real truck doing a burnout. And I remember back when I was a kid when he came to Winchester and supported the truck. That was pretty cool. We went out to see it. And let's see, what else do we have on the box here? On the side, we have a little bit of description of Tyrone Malone and the truck. And then, of course, on the ends, you have the same cover picture that's on the top of the box. And you also have a picture of the engine and the truck with the hood up there, and then a side profile of it and some more description. And on the bottom, you have the parts layout that's actually in the box, the different trees and the decals and everything. So typical round two, modern day round two AMT stuff there. And next, we'll go ahead and get out of the way all the extras that comes in the box other than the kit. And then I'll pan the camera down and we'll get started on all the different parts that's in the kit. And we'll go from there on that part. Let's see, the first thing I have is for your round two, you can get a newsletter from them, and this is their card. You just fill it out and send it in, or you can go online and sign up for that. That's in the box. And they also have a 2015 or 2016? Should have looked at that a little bit better. Should have got prepared before I got on camera here. What do we have? I'm not sure which one this is. It says coming soon. It's got a bunch of different models that are being released, probably for this year, because I see the Cosmic Charger on here and the Mac DM600 and a few others. So, and then they have some diecast cars that are being released and also some slot cars. So that's in here. Round 2 products for 2015. That's what the catalog is. And they give you one of the mini boxes, which is the actual model box, but just in miniature, something AMT's been doing for a while now. And I have yet to put one of those together. I need to do that one day because I have a bunch of them laying around here. And let's see, next off we have a nice color picture of the Super Boss truck. And it looks like it's probably filmed or taken at Bonneville, most likely. From the surroundings, but very nice picture of it, and then a little bit of a description on the back of the truck. So that's pretty cool, and especially if you're doing some you're doing a replica of it or whatever, you can kind of sit this over to the side of your workbench or hang it up in front of you, and you have a reference photo of it. And let's see, next we have the decals, which is pretty in-depth as far as pieces. And this is what the decal sheet looks like. A lot of decals on there. They don't look to be real thick. I actually think these may be a dream to put on. They look pretty good. So when we get started on this project, we'll find out and see how that goes. But and also in the decals, there's another little individual decal that has two on it, and I'm not sure what they're for right now, but I'd have to read through the instructions to find out. But the decals do look very nice. They have the light blue and the red. And then, of course, you paint the truck white and blue, a darker blue. And let's see, that's on that. And next we move on to the instructions, which is the typical AMT instruction sheet, the fold-out newspaper style. And we start out on that by doing the engine. And I'll turn it around here so everybody can see it. You have the engine there, and then the wheels, the chassis, front suspension, and the rear suspension on this side. And also a parts layout right over here. And on the back, we have the final assemblies, finishing up the chassis and the hood, the interior, painting and the details, final assemblies, all that. So it's on the front and back sides of that, and that's everything you need to know about putting it together. For the most part, not everything, but that gets you in the neighborhood. All right, so next we're going to go ahead and pan the camera down, and we're going to go through the 9 parts bags that's in this kit. It does seem to have a lot of parts bags, but not a whole lot of parts. So we'll see what we got here, and hopefully, once I get everything unbagged, it lives up to my expectations, and we'll see. So here we go. Okay, like I said, we have 9 different parts bags, and I went ahead and opened the ends of all of them, but everything is still in the bags right now. So first thing I'll do is I'll go to the tires, and I noticed that these are pad printed and look to be pretty decent. And you have 4 tires for the rear, and they all have the Bandag Tyrone Malone, which was the tire that he used, one of his signature things. And they are pad printed. They're slicks, look pretty decent. Could use some sanding. They're kind of a little bit concave in the center, so a little bit of careful sanding on that and dressing up, and they should be good. The sidewall detail looks pretty nice. Now the front ones are a smaller, the rim diameter is a little smaller, and they are shaped like a wedge. So that's something to definitely take a look at when you're getting ready to build this model. The front tires are shaped at an angle across the tread, so that's something that you want to go in there and sand that down flat with a sanding stick to make sure, you know, when you finish the model that everything is sitting flat on the table the way it should on a well-built model. But other than, you know, a couple little sanding issues, they look real good. The pad printing looks nice. They look to be in scale. And they have a nice soft feel to them. So that's the tires. And next we'll move on to the rear body, which is the second parts bag. And that's all that's in this parts bag. I see a couple scratches up on top of mine here. Right up on this section here that'll probably need to be sanded out. Also a couple scratches up through here. And the one thing that I did notice about this kit just looking through the parts bags was they actually give you a raised line to paint and to line up your decals on. And I'm not sure if I like that or not. It's not raised a whole lot, but in a competition model, I'm not sure if that'll show up, so that may be something that has to be sanded out. Or by the time that you get the paint on, use that as a guide, get the paint on and the decals on, you may be able to go over top of that with a clear coat and seal everything down, and it may not show up at all. But we'll see as we get into building it when that time comes, and see what happens there. But a couple injector pin marks underneath the body, nothing major. They're not real deep. It does have a textured finish underneath of the body, underneath the rear body, so doesn't look too bad in there. This one here is a little deep, but should sand out pretty good and then get the texture back in it if you're displaying it on a mirror. So that's the rear body. And next we'll move on to the clear parts, which is basically 2 pieces. It's the side glass, the windshield, and the back all in one piece here. There is 4 injector pin marks at the very top of this, and I normally go in and trim out a lot of this upper area right here and thin it out a lot. That way when you look up inside of the truck, you don't see all this extra. And they also have another little piece here that's probably for the it's for the passenger side door glass at the bottom of the door. And that's all we have for the clear parts. Look pretty good, nice and clear, pretty thick like AMT usually is. So for you real particular guys, myself included, you'll probably want to thin this out a little bit, sand it down and then buff everything back out to get it clear again. Next we have the hood assembly, which looks to be molded pretty good. Now they do have the trademark inked on. That looks almost like it's pad printed also underneath of the hood. And the underneath of the hood could stand some sanding. They put texture in it, but it also has a number one cast in it. Four big injector pin marks right here. And let's see if we can get that to zoom in and see it. You can see them there. So the underneath of the hood is going to need a little bit of cleanup underneath of the fenders. Nothing major. Like I say, there is the raised lines on the outside where it looks like there are guidelines for lining up the decals and the paintwork. There is a pretty nasty mold line right through here that's going to have to be taken care of on both sides. The left side seems to be worse. But sink marks, I don't really see a whole lot in it. Might be a couple here and there, but the good thing about that also is with this many decals and different colors of paint that has to go on it, then plus a clear coat, a lot of very shallow sink marks will disappear by the time you get this thing wet sanded and buffed. So don't be scared of any of that. But the hood looks to be molded very well. Next we move on to the cab assembly. Same thing, looks pretty good. Has four big raised injector pin marks in, or actually six of them, inside there. Something else that'll need to be addressed. But the casting and everything looks real good. Some mold line running across here and then up and then around the back of the cab and then down these sides. So all this will have to be cleaned up real nice. You know, and I say cleaned up real nice if you're into competition building. If you're going to take this to, you know, compete, you're going to need to clean all that stuff up and make sure it's not there. If you're just building for yourself, you know, a slight amount of cleanup on this and you'll be good to go. So don't be discouraged by my thoughts on, you know, a lot of cleanup on the mold lines and stuff. That's just coming from a competition standpoint. But overall, it looks to be molded very well. So that's a plus on that. And next we'll move on to something that a lot of you guys like. Me personally, I end up stripping all this and doing it with either spastix or alquad or whatever, or some type of metalizer. But that's the chrome trees. And we have the exhaust on here, which is drilled on the ends. Looks pretty decent. And the turbos are on here, the valve covers, the fifth wheel, just some odds and ends things. All look to be pretty decent if you were to keep the chrome. There is some mold lines under the chrome like usual, but you know, for you guys that aren't into competition, that's no big deal. You don't need to mess with any of that. It does look like the chrome is very well put on. But for the most part, I mean, for the competition builders out there, you're going to strip all this anyway to clean all the mold lines and the sink marks and stuff up and redo it. So no big deal on that part. And the next tree, you have the wheels on it, the rear wing supports, some brake chambers, the headlights, the grill. The chrome on the grill looks very nice, other than the typical mold lines you got to get rid of, and injector pin marks on the inside. But looks to be done very well, so that's pretty cool. Especially for the guys, like I say, that's not into competition, I think this chrome could probably come right off the parts trees and go right onto your model. Okay, next we'll move on to the frame and the, what else do we have in here? It looks like the frame cross members. This is the frame rails, and they look to be cast very well, not a lot of flash on them. This is the torsion bar rear suspension, and the leaf springs are cast into the frame, and the front frame horns there, but look pretty decent. A few raised injector pin marks, typical AMT on the inside. And some of the cross members and just the underbill, the hood hinges are on here. Like I say, again, you got a few, you know, mold lines, a little bit of flash, and some injector pin marks, nothing major. I see the front skis for the underneath of the front leaf springs that he used on that truck. They're on here. Probably need to be thinned a little bit, but that's a cool thing that they added to the kit. I was kind of wondering if they would, and there they are. So that all looks to be pretty decent. Okay, next we'll move on to the next parts bag here, and this looks to be the engine. Let's see, we have engine here, the front and rear wings. This truck has a rear wing on it. It has a wing on top of the hood and a wing on both fenders. And there is some sink marks in the rear wing. I can see that already. And also some very deep injector pin marks. Actually, every one of the wings is like that. So for you guys that aren't real picky about this, you can probably be able to go ahead and you know, just lightly clean it up and good to go. For the competition builders out there, the wings themselves are going to require a little bit of work. And I'll hold it up here and let you see how deep those injector pin marks are in that wing. But nothing major. Like I say, it's just a matter of cleaning up, and you know, it's all part of the basics. I've done tutorials on that, so if you need any help with you know, addressing these items here, just check out some of my archives and it'll show you step by step how to do that. And let's see, we have the engine block. Now this is a 12 cylinder Detroit diesel that's in this with a Allison automatic transmission, and all that looks to be cast very well. The front I-beams on here, the power steering mechanism, and these here, this is the heads, some of the front engine case, the back of the transmission. This one here is the oil pan and the superchargers, the oil filters, and some various other parts. Not a lot of flash, a little bit, but nothing major. Actually, it's cast, from what I see, it's cast very well for an older kit that's being re-released. And the last parts bag that we have is, as soon as I get everything unwound here, let's see, we have the rear panel for the truck, the dash is on here, the seat risers, the shifter tower, all looks to be pretty good. The dash has nice detailing on it. Some injector pin marks underneath, nothing major. These here are raised, so they're easy to get rid of. And we have some more interior parts and the interior bucket itself with some cast in. Let's see, what all do we have on there? Did they put any injector pin marks? Yeah, they actually put a couple in there. But it has the door panel detail cast into it. Pretty shallow, but with some scribe work, you could actually scribe that in and make it a little deeper. Would look real nice. But overall, looks pretty decent. And then we have the seats and the radiator here. The radiator's two-piece, of course. That all looks to be molded very well. And we have the firewall and the steering wheel. And the firewall has, of course, the back of the firewall is very clean, but when you turn the firewall around, you can see the two massive injector pin marks right there on the flat panels that they put on it. Not sure why they did it that way, but that's something that's going to need to be cleaned up. At least I think that's the front side. It looks to me like it's the front side because the dog box is open right there. So we'll have to check that out as we go on in, you know, in the build process when it starts. But shouldn't be too bad to clean up. And the last parts three we have is fuel tank, the rear ends, the brake drums, and a few odds and ends panels. I see the parachutes are on here and a couple other things. The lubrifier's on here. And that all looks to be molded very well. A little bit of flash, nothing major. So overall, from what I'm seeing so far on this kit, I think it looks to be a pretty decent re-release. And anybody that's looking to build a truck model, you know, give it a shot. Go out and buy one. I picked this up at Hobby Lobby with a 40% off coupon. I think it was like $25, something like that, which wasn't bad. So, you know, check that out and, you know, do a video on it or whatever and let us see the progress. But that's my review on the AMT re-release Super Boss kit. So if you have any questions or concerns, just leave me a comment on the video and we'll be more than glad to answer them for you. Like always, I thank you for watching and supporting Showtime Studios, and we'll talk to you later. Bye-bye.